On October 11, 2009, a massive landslide carrying 40 million cubic yards of debris destroyed a half mile of Highway 410, about 28 miles west of Yakima, Washington. The landslide uplifted the highway and pushed it into the Natchez River. After the dust settled, the surrounding landscape and the river were changed forever.
Initially, it was really a rescue operation, so we partnered up with search and rescue and the local fire departments and the sheriff's office and WSP, and so everybody's initial response was to make sure people were safe.
The Washington State Department of Transportation and South Central Region immediately responded to the natural disaster and closed off 47 miles of Highway 410. Yakima County officials evacuated residents of the Nile Valley and closed the damaged sections of Nile Loop Road, a county road parallel to Highway 410. With winter quickly approaching, it was a race against time to restore access in the Nile Valley.
It became obvious later on that first day that if we were going to restore access, we actually had to get a contractor on board. It was a handshake I did with the county commissioner that said, I'm going to take over the operation of your county road. I'm going to try to make that the state highway detour. And it was later that day and early the next day where we mobilized a contractor, and we actually started working on the county road trying to restore access.
9 days after the landslide, the Department of Transportation was able to open a graveled surfaced emergency access route to all drivers. But the work in the Nile Valley wasn't done. Mother Nature was posing another challenge. This time, it was winter.
The next big thing was happening, you know, right from when we started. We knew we needed to get an alternate route built. Winter's coming, hunting season's coming, Chinook Pass doesn't stay open in the winter, and November, late October, we usually get some significant high water events in the Natchez River. So we knew at that time whatever temporary thing that we built to get them in and out of there would not last through the winter.
11 days after the landslide, the Department of Transportation and their contractor, Selling Construction, started building a portion of the new detour, a 4,000-foot section that was being constructed across the valley and away from the landslide and river channel.
I immediately got my survey crew out there and started working on topographic data, and then also worked with our headquarters to get an aerial flight and get data that way also to put into our computer software to start modeling this the existing conditions, but also worked with our materials crew to look at the existing ground out there and what kind of conditions we have to work with out there.
While the Department of Transportation built the detour, the Yakima County Flood Control Zone District worked on plans for a new river channel that would move the river away from the toe of the landslide to prevent erosion of the slide and withstand future flooding.
Yakima County was in charge of the main design for the larger river that we were going to build. While we were building the temporary detour, and WSDOT was in charge of implementation. So we worked, once again, hand in hand. They would give us design information, and we would start building it and using the material for the long-term detour. It was forecasted that Nile Road would be overtopped on a Tuesday. We were set to actually do the channel change on a Wednesday. So we had to accelerate our plans by about 24 hours.
As Yakima County breached the emergency route, the Department of Transportation had to shift traffic onto the partially finished 4,000-foot-long section of the Highway 410 detour.
When we were building that road, we were working against time. The river was coming up, and our temporary road was getting bad. We had to move traffic onto our new road.
45 days after the landslide, the Department of Transportation and Selling Construction finished paving the Highway 410 detour, one day earlier than the Thanksgiving deadline. It took thousands of hours, 75 pieces of equipment, and 100 employees from multiple agencies to restore the Highway 410 transportation corridor to residents of the Nile Valley. However, there is still more work to be done.
Good news is that we're designing a fix right now that will probably either go around or over the toe of the landslide, and we should be able to restore SR 410 back to close to where it was before.
October 11, 2009 is a day the Washington State Department of Transportation will never forget. The emergency response to the Nile Valley landslide showed employees that with effective and efficient collaboration and communications, anything can be accomplished.